the Philippine Police won't be breaking any laws in coordinating with investigators from the International Criminal Court. Former Senator Antonio Trillanes gave that assurance after the Justice Department warned officials who cooperate with the ICC may be held accountable under the law. Trillanes earlier alleged the ICC has contacted dozens of active and retired police personnel regarding the crime against humanity complaints against former President Rodrigo Duterte. Trillanes says the ICC arrest order for Duterte may be out soon.
Ang estimate po natin, itong late second quarter, no? Yun po ang estimate natin. So that is around June. Alam din po ni Duterte yan. Kaya ano na yan, naninikip na dibdib niyan. Kasi sabi nga, mahirap makatulog pag sa mga ganyan. Ibang usapan yan, international tribunal yan. Marami na pong mga malalaking mga tao ang pinakulong ng ICC.
The chief implementer of Duterte's war against drugs, meanwhile, calls Trillanes' claims senseless. Senator Ronald De La Rosa maintains the Marcos administration does not recognize the ICC's jurisdiction over the Philippines. De La Rosa says any government official who cooperates with the ICC will be charged with graft and corrupt practices. The Philippine Medical Association welcomes the upcoming Senate probe on the alleged pyramiding scheme between doctors and a pharmaceutical firm. The group urges physicians and pharma companies to follow ethical standards to preserve the integrity of their profession. The Senate is set to investigate a scheme wherein a company is allegedly recruiting doctors to prescribe their products in exchange for luxurious rewards.
Bumulaga ito sa atin, ano? Bigla na lang because of the whistleblower. So, ang importante kasi sa ating lahat, no? We should be very vigilant as physicians, no? I think kailangan nating critically look at yung mga ganung alok, no? Kasi once inalukan ng ganyan, no? Nagkakaroon tayo ng tinatawag natin na conflict of interest. Ang pagdoktor kasi ay isang bokasyon na bigay buhay at hindi hanap buhay, no? Mm-hmm. Kumbaga na tayo ay tinatrust, no? Trust is the bedrock, no? And integrity. Mm-hmm. Panawagan natin doon sa mga drug companies na ganyan ang ugali. Ayusin din natin ang inyong pamamalakad.
The Pharmaceutical and Healthcare Association of the Philippines also condemning the alleged practice. PHAP says it is appalled by reports. Some of those in the pharmaceutical industry are not abiding by laws and regulations governing their business practices.
More areas in the Philippines placed under a state of calamity due to the prolonged El Nino. The government's El Nino task force said Friday some 105 cities and towns have made the declaration as the total cost of damage to crops in their areas nears 4 billion pesos. The agency says the government continues to provide aid not only to farmers but also to their families. In all, it estimates some 2 million persons are affected by the phenomenon. The task force also assures the public the country's food supply remains stable and those jacking up prices will answer to the law.
The government, again, is not just focusing on agricultural damage, but in helping all those individuals that are affected by this dry spell. Supply of food, particularly rice, is stable, is sufficient, and we're actually expecting an augmentation in the yield because of the ongoing harvesting season from the last cropping season. So there should be no cause for alarm, and there should be no big hikes in the prices of basic commodities because the supply of these basic commodities are still stable.
Ayala Corporation is reviewing all its businesses in a bid to simplify its corporate structure. Meanwhile, Union Bank expects higher growth following the completion of its Citibank acquisition. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual is now on the line with those stories. Jackie?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. Ayala Corporation, one of the country's largest conglomerates, is reviewing all its subsidiaries and units as it prioritizes where to put its resources. It wants to simplify its corporate structure and that of its companies. Speaking to reporters following the company's annual stockholders meeting, Ayala Corporation President and CEO Cesar Consing said they will focus more on businesses that are growing or those that can be scaled up. Some businesses, like its property and energy units, will get bigger capital expenditures this year, but others will have a lower capex. Ayala has earlier announced it was targeting to divest around 50 billion pesos worth of its non-core businesses, like its stake in Light Rail Manila Corp and Manila Water, and they hope to complete that by the end of the year. Ayala Land is also expected to merge all its 34 subsidiaries to simplify its corporate structure. This may be completed by 2026. Ayala is also streamlining its logistics business by integrating Entrego to Air 21. Ayala now looks to pour more resources in sectors they deem they can scale up further, like its health unit, its energy unit, as well as AC Mobility, which is now focusing on electric vehicles. Meanwhile, the Aboitiz-led Union Bank of the Philippines is also looking at higher growth this year following the completion of the acquisition of the Citibank consumer business in the country. This after the bank or Union Bank recorded lower net income in 2023. At the company's virtual annual stockholders meeting, Union Bank President Edwin Bautista announced that the integration and migration of Citibank customers to Union Bank has been completed in March this year, and this will have a positive impact on its financial record because now they no longer will have to have two parallel systems serving both Union Bank and Citibank customers. Union Bank plans to increase further its loan portfolio, credit card business, as it sets its sights to become the largest and most profitable bank in the retail segment of the banking industry. And that's the latest, Denise. Back to you.
Thanks for that, Jackie.